Hello students, in this video we'll discuss about Apache OC tool. What is this Apache OC? OC is a tool that gives the workflow to run and manage multiple related Hadoop jobs. And this OC workflow jobs are represented by DAG, directed acyclic graph. And we can see there are three types of OC jobs are permitted: workflow, coordinator, and bundle. Workflow is nothing but sequence of jobs, right? So if I want to do the second job, I should complete the first one. Unless I complete the first one, I can't move to the second job. So workflow is sequence of jobs. Then what is coordinator? A scheduled workflow job that can run at various time intervals. This is known as coordinator job. And the third is bundle, a higher level of OC abstraction that will batch a set of coordinator job is bundle. So we are having three types of OC jobs. So what is this OC? OC is a tool that gives the workflow. Usually this workflow, it is represented in XML process definition language, right? XML process definition language. So here this workflow will have several nodes, and we can see this nodes. So the first type of node is control flow nodes. So this control flow nodes will give you the start node, end node, and if there is any failure node, it will represent that failure node also. I'll show a simple DAG. See here, this is a simple DAG. What is this DAG? Directed acyclic graph. So this graph will tell you the workflow. So OC is a tool that gives the workflow to run and manage multiple related Hadoop jobs. So this workflow has a start node, end node, and suppose if there is any error, I have to kill my job, right? So I have a failure node also. So this three things, it comes under the control flow nodes. And the action nodes. Action nodes is the place where the actual work is happening. So if I take this symbol DAG, this map reduce word count is my action node. Next is fork or join nodes. Fork is like for performing parallel execution. Right. So I'll take one more example. See here, fork node. Parallelly, two jobs are running. Right. So this is for parallel execution. Fork is for parallel execution. Then what about this join? Join is a place or point. It will wait for all the fork nodes to complete. Once all the fork nodes are completed, right, it will be joined and comes to the next step. That is my join node. So here fork or join nodes. Fork enables parallel execution, as I said, and join node is a point at which all the fork nodes, it is a point to wait for all the fork nodes to complete. And here I have one more control flow nodes. This control flow nodes are my decision nodes. So I have to make decision based upon my previous task. I'll tell an example. See here, decision nodes. So how am I going to decide it? Based upon my previous task, right? So this decision nodes are control flow nodes. So these are the several nodes in your workflow. And as I said, so this OC will give you the workflow in the form of a graph, that is directed acyclic graph. And I'll have an XML file to represent this workflow. So this is my XML file to represent this simple workflow. Right, so this is a very simple DAG workflow. And this is a little complex one with fork and join nodes. As I said, it is having a start node. This start and end nodes are control nodes. This is my action nodes. I have fork and join nodes. I have decision nodes. So this is a little complex OC dark workflow. And now we can see an example how to download this OC example and how to make use of this OC examples. So this OC example is already available in your Hadoop framework. If your Hadoop is version 1, this is the command to extract the OC examples. Right. If it is 2.2, this is the command to extract the OC examples. Once the OC examples are downloaded, what you can do is like just you can change, rename your file. It will be like examples. You can change to OC examples so that it will be little more clear. After changing the name of your example directory, you can put this directory into your Hadoop distributed file system. To place the file in your Hadoop distributed file system, this is the command, put command. Using put command, you can keep your OC example directory in your Hadoop distributed file system. After placing this in your Hadoop distributed file system, right, you can move to the MapReduce example directory. So the first step, it is like just downloading OC examples. I have downloaded, I have renamed, I have placed it by Hadoop distributed file system. The second step is how to run the simple MapReduce example. If I want to run a simple MapReduce example, what you have to do, you have to place this OC example directory in your MapReduce example directory. Right, OC example directory in your MapReduce example directory. And many OC examples will be there. For every OC example, there will be one directory. Right, and this directory will have two files and one library file. The two files are job.properties is one file and workflow.xml is another file. I'll repeat, every OC example has a corresponding directory. This directory has three things, two files and one library file. What are the two files? Job.properties and workflow.xml are the two files. And once you have decided your example, right, you open that job.property file, and this job.property file, it will contain the path and the ports needed. Right. So here you can open this job.property file and you can change the host name of the name node. So this is the initial host and you can change the host name of your name node. See, it is 832. I have changed to 850. Right. This you have to do. And I'll show this simple XML file, right, for the simple DAG. You have seen an example, right? For this simple DAC, what could be the workflow.xml? Start, this MR represents MapReduce. Action node is your MapReduce word count. You can see here, MapReduce word count. Then if there is any error, you have to kill it or it will come to an end. Right, so for every example, there will be an directory. That directory has two files. You go to job.property file, change the host name of the name node. Afterwards, you can run your OC example. Right. So this is a command to run your OC example. OC job hyphen run hyphen OC. You have to specify this URL. Right. So every time when you run this OC example, you have to specify this URL. If you feel difficult to specify the URL every time, what you can do is like you can create an environment variable and you can store this URL in that environment variable. If you done this, next time when you run this OC example, no need to specify this URL, right? Just one time work. You have to create an environment variable, store the URL in environment variable. That's it. Right. That's how I'm going to run my OC examples. When OC accepts the job, a job ID will be printed. A job ID will be printed. Yeah. Suppose if you get any error like Uzi is not allowed to impersonate Uzi, something like this error, if you get it, you have to include these two properties. Include these two properties in your XML file, foresight.xml file. So this is all about running MapReduce example. Now we can see how to run a Uzi demo application. How to run a Uzi demo application. To run a demo application also, same procedure. Every demo application will have a directory. The directory has three things, two files and one library file. The two files are job.properties and workflow.xml. So go to job.properties. As I have told in the previous step, you have to change the host name of the name node. You change it, then you can run it. Right here, while running, I have not specified the URL. Right, you can check the previous step. Uzi job-run-uzi, this URL I have to specify. So as I told, if you are creating your environment variable, that is just one time work. Next time, when you run your Uzi example, no need to specify this URL. Right, so I have created an environment variable, so I have not used that -uzi option with that URL. Just this is enough to run your Uzi examples. And this Uzi tool has a user interface. And if you want to look at this user interface, this is the command to bring up the Uzi user interface. When you type this command, you'll get your Uzi main console window. Here you can see the list of jobs running, and the recent most job will be the first job, and you are having made various tabs. And if you click this workflow tab, you'll get this Uzi workflow information window. Right, Uzi workflow information window, which has a job ID, name, path, start time, end time, everything it will be specified. And here in the main console window, here you have this job DAG. If you click this job DAG, you'll get this directed acyclic graph for your job. Right, which demo application you are running, that jobs DAG you will get it. Right, what is DAG? Director Acyclic Graph. What does it represents? It represents the workflow. Right, so start cleanup node, and you are making a fork node, and multiple execution is happening. And once this execution is over, you'll get this join node. You'll join everything. You'll do the task. Based upon this task, you will decide it. And at last is your end. This DAG, you can get it. Right, so when you click this job DAG, you'll get the director acyclic graph of the job which is running. Thank you.